Gennady, what do you think about Andre Ward?
What?
What do you think about him? Good fighter, nice guy?
Yes, he's a nice guy. He's a big champion. I respect him. He is a good fighter, you know. He's a good man. He's very correct, you know.
What did you guys tell each other?
Just nothing, just good to see. I know him a long time, you know, just I respect him. He's a good boy. He's a good fighter. He's a good man, you know, just I respect him.
Does it ever surprise you that fans come up to you and say, hey, you're Gennady Golovkin? Does it surprise you sometimes?
Sometimes, because, you know, just my focus, my training, you know, just a lot of people right now, he knows me, you know. Yes.
What would you tell all your fans if they're watching?
Just looking fired. November 2nd, I think it's a great fight. For a great fight for everybody.
You know Mike Perez? You know Magomed Abdulsalamov?
Yeah.
What do you think of their fight?
Oh, this is great fight. It's big test for Magomed, for Mike.
Give me a second.
Two strong guys, you know. Two great fighters, you know,
ready to start.
Okay.
It's perfect. It's a perfect fight for him.
Last question. A lot of fans tell me they want to see you fight Floyd. I know there's different networks, different weight, but what do you think of when people say that they want to see you against the number one?
No, this is impossible.
Not possible. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
There you have it. Gennady Golovkin, facebook.com, and Melissa Crack reporting.
It happened, and again, I don't want it to be premature because they're going to announce their fight with Rodriguez. But if that fight happened, I don't really see that at a catchweight. I don't see Andre coming down from 168, and that would be at a full fledged 168 pounds at super middle.
Gennady,
I'm enjoying fish, but let's get these fights first. Ward fight Rodriguez first. Let's love to fight his first. Then we talk. Let's just these. Big, great fight happens first.
You punch very hard. Everybody that sparred you said, do you work on your punching part? Is that something that came to you naturally?
Yeah, it's natural, yeah. It's hard work every day. Thank you for coach. You know, it's not special work for hard punch now. It's natural and hard work every day. Hard training every day.
And facing a big puncher like Stevenson, do you feel your chin's been tested before? Do you think you have a good chin when you fight strong punchers in there?
I hope.
Well, he's never been on the canvas ever in the amateurs or in the professionals or in sparring, and so you know, I think Gennady has a lot of natural power. That's what Abel said when he first started working with him. He's never really felt kind of the raw power that he had when he first came to the gym. What was that, 4 years ago now, coaches? And you saw that in the amateurs also when he stopped the Boutte, you know, with headgear on and with the amateur gloves. You know, he's had a lot of power in the amateurs, and Abel has been able to refine that power and add a lot of different angles and different combinations to what Gennady had already brought with him from his amateur career. So whether it's a left hook where he's knocked out a lot of guys like the Juan Simon fight, a lot of people don't realize that he's stopped, like Juan Simon fought some great names, Arthur Abraham and Stieglitz in Germany, but he's never been stopped ever in his career, and Gennady knocked him out with one punch in the first round with a left hook. Same thing with Ishida. I mean, Ishida stopped James Kirkland and had some losses, but he'd never been stopped before in his career, and Gennady stopped him in the third round. So these are the type of guys that are willing to get in the ring with him, very durable in their own right, and the way Gennady takes them apart is just making a statement as you know, this is something, or someone, I should say, to watch. And the way Abel has crafted his strategy is just like, you know, watching a master in the ring, what he's able to do.